Food is awesome.
Food.
Cannot miss the food.
Celebrations amazing.
What up, guys? This is Korea.
Toast. And Amin.
And Amir.
I almost said Americ. So, Amin is Eric. Mm-hmm. So, today we're going to be watching a introduction to Indian cultural heritage. Yeah, Indian culture and tradition, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, we get to explore 5 minutes of Indian culture and tradition.
Uh-huh.
So, let's test our knowledge, okay?
Sure.
Okay. So, without further ado, let's go!
Let's
watch!
Hello friends!
Hello!
Welcome to the exam based general awareness learning series. In this series of videos, we'll be knowing the importance of culture and its brief overlook.
Okay.
In the first session, we'll be knowing gist of everything.
Everything.
Good balance.
Yeah.
Will be covered in the upcoming videos.
So let's test our knowledge.
Which one you want to see first in the series of
videos? Let's make sure to leave in the comments, okay?
Let's leave in the comments, yeah.
1.3 million.
Oh, we know that.
But it's growing, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna overtake China.
Land of many cultural
probably soon.
Soon. In a few years.
Unity through diversity.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I know the motto. Unity through
diversity. Yeah.
It's a diverse country, and of course.
By many of the foreign countries, like United States, India is also a federal union.
Oh, federal union, yeah.
Where almost all of its states carries
different states
languages
with different languages and different cultures.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Indian civilization is very ancient.
Very ancient. Indus Valley Civilization.
I learned about India through Indus Valley Civilization. First.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Oh, wow.
When I was in middle school.
Yeah. The Valley period was a time in Indian history.
And caste system began in India.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, Mughal Empire was the last and the strongest Islamic empire in India.
There are new.
So because of this unity
we,
diversity,
no,
different cultural identities only, India is known as the subcontinent.
There are new too.
So here we see India in people. People with different clothing, totally different, right?
Of course.
People with different
food is awesome.
Food.
Cannot miss the food.
Celebrations, amazing.
People living in different localities like urban, semi-urban, or rural.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
This is how people carries or live in different localities. So India is also mainly classified into four major sections.
Four major sections, which are?
One is
North India, okay.
North India, of course.
New Delhi, right?
In North India is New Delhi. And the Eastern
Eastern India,
Kolkata.
Eastern India. City in Eastern India is Kolkata. Western India.
Western India, Mumbai,
of course.
Mumbai
right.
is the metropolitan city.
With the beach.
Western India.
Yeah.
And South India.
South India.
South India is the metropolitan
Chennai.
City.
Yes.
Indian people.
Oh, really? What is it?
Is it South India food?
Oh. It's like banana leaves, I guess.
Yeah, banana leaves, yeah.
North Indian people prefer to eat
vegetables,
meat,
masala.
And South Indian food always carries rice. So all over the India.
A lot of them are vegetables too, right? Vegetarians. Amazing.
Tandoori chicken?
Oh, yes.
However, cows are considered sacrifice.
Oh,
roasted chicken, I think.
Chicken, yes. How do you capture it? And the spices.
Yeah, like
masala spices.
Oh, coffee, man. Coffee.
India has a very good soil, really.
Religion in India is characterized by a diversity of religious beliefs and practices. The Indian subcontinent is the birthplace of four of the world's major religions.
Yes.
Hinduism,
Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, Christianity.
With the people coming and settling from foreign.
And many religions originate from India, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Majority of the people living in India following Christianity and Islam also.
Yes, there are.
Taj Mahal, Taj Mahal.
Historical monuments. India is home to many historical monuments. Mughals and the South Indian kings.
Yes.
And prior to that, those Hindu kings have built so many monuments across India.
Of course.
And the important like ones to mention are Taj Mahal.
Taj Mahal.
Brahadishwara Temple.
Ah, yes, this one.
Have you been there?
No, it's too far.
Yeah,
this one is
Mahabalipuram, Khajuraho, and the list is a long one.
I think I've skimmed through most of them.
Yeah. Next comes is music.
The music. Yes. You're used to, right?
Hindustani and Karnataka are popularly known traditional music of India. Hindustani means classical music of South India.
Okay.
Carnatic means classical music of South India.
Carnatics.
Melody, drone, tala are some of the traditional elements of Indian music. String, wind, percussion are some of the most commonly used instruments in Indian music. The next comes is
dances.
Is a big part of culture in India.
Is an ancient and celebrated cultural tradition in India. Folk dances abound all across the country, and huge crowds of people can be found dancing at festivals and weddings. Dance and
songs are
heavily in Indian
cinema
also.
Wow, Bollywood.
Hollywood, Hollywood, Bollywood, and everything you see songs that feature dances.
Its
roots from six of the most important classical dance forms there. Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, Kathak, Manipuri, Kuchipudi,
so many kinds of dances.
You covered them a lot,
right? In separate video.
Paris?
There are many other cultural traditions exist in India that everyone should know. Especially those who are preparing for competitive examinations. We'll be seeing all these in our upcoming videos. Comment your favorite topic.
So make sure to comment.
All these things.
Yeah.
You want dance as a first video. You want our cultural traditions like music or historic monuments as a first video. Different kind of foods. There are many, many topics coming in this series.
Wow, so I think we knew most of them, right?
We knew a lot,
I don't think I knew most of the names of the dances and the temples or the monuments, right?
Comparing from the beginning of the Korean dance and now, have you learned a lot?
There have been some major updates in our knowledge in terms of relations to India.
To begin with, like, when I started to react to videos, I didn't really know about India actually.
That was true.
You introduced me a lot of culture of India, and now I know quite a lot. But there's just so many to learn about India.
But India is a subcontinent.
Yeah, India is like...
It's not just one country.
One country.
It is one country, but it's a federal union kind of.
Different dialects, different food, different language, different...
Different everything.
Different everything.
That's why it's diversity.
Unity
is diversity.
University, I know.
University
and diversity? No.
Unity
and diversity.
Yes.
Unity and diversity.
It's pretty easy to remember, right?
Okay.
City. Unity, diverse.
Unity by diversity. Yeah, I like that. Yeah.
Anyway.
Thank you.
What would you like to learn more? What should you call it?
First of all, I want to learn about food and language.
Language. Mm-hmm. Okay. I want to learn about temples, like the monuments, and religion. How's that?
Like history, religion.
Yeah, history.
Okay,
yeah.
Our different tastes, right?
India has a lot of mystery.
Mysteries. I'm just more like a foodie guy.
I'm just more of a mysterious guy.
Okay.
Right?
Okay, thank you. Mystery.
Yes.
Mystery.
Yeah.
I like
mysterious.
I like that. Mystery.
I think I like that too.
I like that.
Wow. Alright, so today we had a chance to watch a video called Introduction to Indian Culture Heritage. So it was an introduction, so we knew most of them. But let's dig deeper into it.
Yep,
one by one.
Dig it.
Yeah, dig. And thank you so much for watching. And if you like that video, please subscribe and give us a big thumbs up. And we'll see you guys back very soon, okay? So stay tuned. Bye bye. Philippine Lange.